Good morning, everyone. Yeah, as you've just been told, myself and Grant decided to swap talks because my photos are nicely from what he presented to you all yesterday. So what I'm presenting out to you today is a database of aquatic weeds and their biocontrol agents in South Africa. And I'll show you how it can be a tool for pretty much everyone to see today. I'm just going to give you a brief outline of where this database has come from and how it's put together, and then I'll give you a brief case study using data from Periscope. So the data that is housed in this database is a result of 6 years of national aquatic weed surveys, which is conducted by the Biological Control Unit of Rhodes University, funded by Wicked for Water. During these surveys, the primary focus is on the 5 weeds, red water fern, azolla, gribweeds, Alvinia molesta, water hyacinth, according to Crespi's, parrot's feather, Marinophyllum aquaticum, and water lettuce, Pisco stratiatus. On these surveys, we measure proxies of plant health and record the damage caused by the biocontrol agents at the site. We also take digital photographs for later reference. So why do we need this database? Well, we've got all these years of data that are currently sitting on a shelf in files and up till now have not been utilized in much depth. So using this database, we can make the data accessible. We can improve our data security by making several copies and backups and storing them in different positions. It finally makes the data shareable. I can simply email data to people as and when required. And it makes the data in a format that can be analyzed. Who exactly is this database targeted at? Well, the answer to that question is anyone and everyone with an interest in aquatic weeds in South Africa. In particular, it will be useful for managers of water bodies as well as implementation officers and all the researchers in the field. It will allow us to assess the risk posed by surrounding infested water bodies on a particular water body. It allows us to look at the efficacy of current and past management strategies, and will also allow the monitoring of the populations of the weeds and the biocontrol agents in the long term. The ultimate goal with this data is to set up an interactive web map, freely accessible to anyone, of the weeds and the control agents around the country. So let's take a closer look at the database. Well, firstly, the data pertains to the sites themselves, and we store information about the geographic locality and a unique site name that we give the site. This is just a map of all the sites currently on the database, of which there are over 900 in all of our provinces. This is an example of the data that we entered into the site table. I've used our local one that Grant showed yesterday. It's in Francis Marine. It's on a it's a small little dam in a boat building factory premises. We give it a coordinates, record what type of water body it is, any comments specific to the site, and if it falls on a river system, exactly which system. From this form, we can add new sites, delete sites if we discover that they are inaccurate. We can add in observations for the site, and we can add information on the releases made at this site. Furthermore, we can open Google Earth and get an aerial image of the site. If we do that, there's the Francis Marine, and you would have all driven past the site on your way into Captain Francis. Yeah. Secondly, the database stores information about the observations of the weeds and agents. There are currently over 1,500 records which I have painstakingly entered. And this is where we capture our survey data. Again, I'm using our site here, the Francis Marine, and it says Sylvania Modesta, and the biocontrol agent, Sergio Vegas, Sylvania. Every time we visit a site, it will get a unique record like this. We record the percent cover of the weed, This year it was 98% and it's dropping. The damage caused by the agent, currently about 45%. We reported other aquatics that occurred at the site. This can be important for early detection and rapid response program. Any comments that are pertinent to the site, who the assessors were and the data capture. This is just to keep track of where the data is coming from and if we have any reliability issues or we suspect the records are not accurate, then we can go back to these people and question them further. We also have a link to the photos. And if we just check one quickly, there it is. It's the same one Grant showed yesterday. With the brown spreading out from the point of release of the search radius biocontrol agent. At sites where water hyacinth occurs, the assessors take 10 plants that are representative of the population of water hyacinth, and various measures of plant health and the damage caused by the biocontrol agents are recorded. We record which agents are present, and again, what the damage caused, and any comments for the site. So now that you've seen the nuts and bolts of the database, I'll just quickly present a case study to start giving you some idea of what we can do with this database. Firstly, we can look at the data at a very coarse scale. Our queries can be fairly automated for simple data. You can enter any one of these or a combination of them to get your desired results. In this case, I just wanted all the data where parents feather was found. So we can either run that query and get a nice summary table, or you can export it straight to Excel for further calculations and data manipulation. If we run that query, we generate 137 records. And here you see the province where the site is, what the site is called, the weed, just to make sure it's right, the year that the record was recorded, and the agent's presence or absence. To these data, I added all the sites that occurred here where the weed was not recorded in a year to get a full history of what's happening at these sites. I then plotted the data on maps for every year since 2008. And you can see we visited from 20 to about 30 sites normally. This year they weren't lazy, there was just big floods in the country, so most of the sites weren't accessible. Then I calculated the percentage of the sites where perhaps that occurred that had the biocontrol agent. I'm just sorry, the colours here. The purple is where the perhaps that occurred without the biocontrol agent. The orange are where the agent was found with the perhaps feather, and the green are the points where the weed was not found in that year. And in most of these years, the proportion of sites with agents was pretty good, up to 94%. Looking at the past 2 years, again, we visited from the mid to high 20s sites, and still a fairly good proportion of those sites had the biocontrol agent. And this year, so far, there's 74% coverage. We still to do the northern reaches of the country. We'll add a few more sites to that. So moving on to a finer scale, we can investigate site-level information. At sites with parrot feather, we go to these hideous places with gargantuan mountains in the background, and we do three random quadrants on the parrot feather bed. And then within the quadrant, the number of stems or parrots that are counted and the number of those stems that have evidence of feeding damage is reported. So from this we get firstly a density estimate of the site and the damage caused by the control agent. When we compare 2008 to 2013, the pink is the stems in the quadrant and the blue is the proportion of those that are damaged. We see in 2008, it was just over 60 stems per quadrant, and this year, that has pretty much been halved. So we can see our control agents are doing their job. And in both 2008 and 2013, there was a high proportion of these stems that were damaged by Lysopia. In the databases, the young lifespan of only about 9 months, we already received and fulfilled several requests for data. These have been from CRB for records of Slovenian minister and Minister Davis agent for a paper they're writing. A request from BITS for the Honest Project looking at Vortice and their various agents around the country. And finally, we got in there and recently presented a poster in Canada from Parrots Feather and the Power Control Agent. Thank you very much. And if you would like to get data or supervise with data, you can contact us on those addresses. And that's a link to our website.
Okay, I think we have got plenty of time for questions or comments.
Hello, Mike. Does your data automatically get fed to Leslie's database, the South African Cloud Data Atlas, or is there a decision to keep Waterbees separate from that?
It doesn't matter, but we can easily communicate about it, and we do have intentions to speak about it. So we have a chance to check it
easily. I'll put in a request for this.
So previously there's been automatic
transfer.
It's still very young, so we need to set up all this. Let's go back.
I put a record of Parrot's Feather for you up in the north, so you can investigate.
Okay. Thank you very much.